One of the highly effective habits of top 1% engineers is to learn from text. Now, video-based formats are good. You can learn a lot from there. But when you have access to the information that very few people have, that you can only get from text. And this is something that I want to talk in this particular video. How to read and learn from the technical books or text. I have been reading books from last 4 to 5 years. And believe me, this is one of the best habits that you can develop because this changed my life completely. As you can see it over here, I have read so many books. It changed the way I think about the world. Think about this, when you read technical books, you get everything at one place. The author of that particular book spends around 2 to 3 years researching, understanding and writing that particular book and gives you everything in structured format. The same goes with the white papers or the research paper. These are some of the gold mines that you should explore if you want to become a top engineer. So in this video, I want to give you the quick guide on how you can get started reading technical books, learn from them and retain the knowledge for the future. Now, before we get started, I just want to burst your one myth that reading technical books are difficult. A lot of people come to me and tell me that reading technical books are boring and difficult to understand. This is the pre-built mindset you might have because you were exposed to the reference book in schools or college because you were preparing for the exam. But most of the technical books in today's world are very easy to understand. They are just like novel. You can read them text by text and you will understand most of it. The difficult part here is not reading the technical book. It is learning the new concept. So even if you watch the video and if you are just getting started, it might be a little bit difficult to understand at the start. So pay attention to this. Like when you get started learning any new topic, the first step here is to get introduced to the new information. After that, you will analyze it. Your brain either accepts or rejects it. It starts processing it. And the more you repeat it, the more you learn and grow in your life. So remove this myth that reading the technical books are difficult. Learning new topic is difficult at the start, but more you repeat it and more you stick to it, it will get easier. So once you begin with this right mindset, then we can talk about how to get started reading technical books. Now here's the thing, in general, there are two types of technical books available in the market in today's world. The first type is just theory based that only have text. And the second type of book is more towards hands-on based on the projects. So we will talk about both of these types. First, we will understand how to read the theoretical and conceptual book. These are the books that only have the theoretical information about different topics and concepts. One of the best resources if you want to understand the technology from the fundamental level. It is very difficult to find all of these information in the videos, but these types of technical books will give you access to all of these information. The advantage from learning difficult text is that it makes learning everything else so much easier. So once you understand the tech from the fundamental level, you will realize that most of the modern tools are just an abstraction or layer on top of the core fundamentals. And these fundamentals do not change for the longer period of time. So now you know why you should read all of these difficult books, but how to read them? The simple answer is you just get started with the reading. Now, before you click off from this video, listen to me first. Learning to read technical books is like going to the gym. You don't go to gym at the first day and start lifting 50 kg of dumbbell. You start small and you start with a 2.5 kg or 5 kg of dumbbell. This is what you should get started with. The same thing applies here. When you decide to learn from the technical books, do not put pressure on yourself that you have to finish everything today or you have to understand everything that you read. This is the biggest misconception people have that, okay, if I start reading this technical books, I should understand each and every word. This is not how things work when you get started. I have read this particular book 3 to 4 times, right? This is the data intensive application. This is completely theory based book. This does not have any code examples or anything. Now, when I got started reading this book for the first time, I did not understand a single word. This is one of the most difficult texts that I was reading at that time. But I kept reading it forward and it started making sense in 3rd or 4th chapter. So these types of books are always boring to read. When you get started, you will get different dots. But if you stick to it for a few days or weeks, it will start connecting everything together. So the important point here is that you should start small. Start with the 1 page a day. This book is around 400 pages long. And if you want to read one single book throughout this entire year, then if you read like 2 to 3 pages a day, you can complete this entire book by end of the year. Now, this brings me to my second point. You don't have to read 50 books. You don't have to read this book from first page to the last page. You don't have to understand every single paragraph that is written. It's all good. All of these are the wrong mindset that you have about learning. That you have to finish reading 50 books. That you have to read each and every single word and understand from this particular book. Even if you understand 30 to 40% from this book, that's totally fine. No one really understands everything. You understand some part and you can skip some part. You don't have to read this book from first page to last page. If you skip something, that is totally fine. If you understand something, that is totally fine. Okay, so don't have all of these wrong mindset that, okay, you have to understand every single thing. Just get started. The goal here is not to finish reading all of these books. The goal here is to get in the habit of reading this difficult text. So at the end of this video, we will talk about how to build a proper routine for reading all of these books. But let's talk about the second type of book, that is like more hands-on with the practical examples. Now these books are one of the best books if you want to learn any new topic. Why? Because with the theory, you also get the practical examples. The structure is usually same. You get some theoretical knowledge, but with that knowledge, you also get the practical code example that you can directly apply and see the output. For example, at the start of my career, I read this book, Hands-on Machine Learning with a Scikit-Learn, TensorFlow and Keras. It was the gold mine if you want to get into the data science in machine learning field, because this book had everything that you need to know, from theoretical understanding, from the practical how to use the latest tools. As you can see, after theory, you get the code samples. These are also available on the GitHub repository. You can just read this book and execute the code while you are reading it. These types of books are much easier to read because you get to execute the code and understand the theoretical concept then and there. Now, one advice I would like to give is that when you learn from all of these books, you should not do the copy paste, Control C, Control V. If you want to follow along, you should type the code by yourself. This will give you the hands-on practice of writing code and boost your confidence. Now, these are the mainly two types of books that you will find in the market. The first type, the theoretical based. If you can get the hard copy, that is good. If you can't, then just read from the PDFs or ebooks. For the second type, I highly recommend getting the PDF only because you get to follow along while writing the code. I usually recommend people to start from the PDF. And if you like the book, especially the theoretical one, then you can order the physical copy. Now we talked about a lot of good stuff. So if you found it helpful, then don't forget to hit that like button. That keeps me motivated to create more of this content. And also hit the subscribe button if you are new here. Now let's talk about how to build a routine to read all of these books and some of the strategies that I have used. Now the first step, start with a simple goal. Again, you don't have to read 50 books. You don't have to read each and every paragraph from this book. All you have to do is just get started. So just keep your goal very simple. In this particular year, I will read 3 technical books. So every 4 months, I will read one book. I will recommend some of the books at the end of this video, so don't worry about it. After you define your goal, then make a commitment that no matter how hard it gets, no matter how boring it gets, you will stick to the entire process because it will make sense in the future. Once you make this commitment, then start small. 1 page a day for 1 week, 5 pages for 2nd week, 10 pages a day for 3rd week, and 20 pages a day for the 4th week. At the end of the month, you will complete reading 250 pages. That's half of this particular book. So the way you can do that is just keep the 30 minutes out of your day. It can be after waking up, going before bed, or if you're traveling daily for the office, then you can also read it from the PDF. All you need is 30 minutes for the reading. That's it. Now at the end, if you want to retain this knowledge, you can start taking the notes. Now the simple way is just directly highlight the text, or if you want to take the notes separately, all you can do is just open the Word document and start pasting your content. It doesn't have to be any fancy. All you're doing is that whatever the information that you find useful, you can just copy and paste it in the Word document, or you can use any note-taking application like the Apple Notes, Notion. I usually prefer using the Obsidian for my Apache Spark course. I'm building this note structure for my students where they can get access to everything at one place. On Obsidian, you can create the backlinks to easily track the new information. If you want me to create the detailed video on the Obsidian and how I take notes, then let me know in the comments. I will make that for you. If you're still watching this video, then you can comment it out. I watched this video till the end. That way, I will know that you completed the entire video and you are very serious about this. Now, here's the thing. Read these technical books as a curiosity to learn something new. You might or you might not use this information in the future, but the act of understanding something that a lot of people skip, that gives you the confidence. Doing hard things is always rewarding. So don't read these books just because you want to get a job or something. Learn to enjoy the process of reading all of these difficult texts. It'll help me a lot in my career, and I'm 100% sure if you stick to this, it will definitely help you to grow in your career. At the end, I just want to leave you with this quote from the Steve Jobs. You can't connect the dots looking forward. You can only connect them looking backwards. So you have to trust that the dots will somehow connect in your future. This was all from this video. I hope you understood and learned something new. If you did, then don't forget to hit the like button. Subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next video.